Hello everyone, this is Sindhu David, your computer teacher. Welcome you all once again after Diwali vacation to the computer online class. In this video, I will explain Unit 3, Digital Documentation, some more formatting tools and paragraph page setup. This is my video number 4. So let's start Unit 3, Digital Documentation, Part 4. Now students, I will tell you some more formatting tools in LibreOffice Writer. So let's start with paragraph style. Paragraph, as you know, can have the several sentences or a single sentence. Every paragraph in a LibreOffice Writer document has a paragraph style. The paragraph style setting have a pop-down window you can see over here. By clicking on the paragraph style, you can get the pop-down window. From there you can select your choice. So let's start to apply the paragraph style in our report. First we will see how to change the indent in a paragraph. You click anywhere in your paragraph and just go to the menu. Here you can see increase indent. Indent means the space left by a paragraph. See, you can increase indent as well as you can decrease the indent as per your choice. Now come to the aligning of the paragraph. This alignment can be left, right, center or and justify. To align the paragraph, place a text cursor in the title paragraph. Select the appropriate tool. If you want to change the alignment of this paragraph, you have to select, this is center alignment. You can see the text is aligned in the center. You can go for the right alignment. The text started with the right margin. Then you can come to the justify. Justify alignment will use the full space of a line. And you can use the left alignment. This text is aligned just according to the left margin. But I choose justify, means I want to use the full space of the line. So you can change here also. As I said, you have to click 3 times the cursor and this paragraph will get selected. Then you click on justify. Now you can see this justify. Now your text is arranged. It is left alignment and the right alignment also. No space is left in the left margin, near the left margin or the near the right margin. Now student, we will see 3 more tools: font color, highlighting and background tool on the format toolbar. To change the font color, select the small down pointing arrow on the right edge of the font color tool and select the color from the color box. First select the text you want to change the color. I want to change the color of your business process company. Then I will go to the small down pointing arrow and I will choose the color of my choice, rectangle. You can see the font color gets changed. Now how to change the highlight color? Again you have to select the area where you want to highlight your text, then go to the next small down pointing arrow and select the color. Student, you can assign the bullet or numbering to the list items in the document by using the options on the bullets and numbering toolbar. Now I will show you how to create a nested list by using the buttons on the bullets and numbering toolbar. First you select the text which you want to enlist it, then come over here. Here you can see toggle number list. When you click here, you will get the different types of numbering. I start with this one. I can change to the Roman numbers. I can use the alphabets, small, capital letter, as well as I can use more numbering, means other than whatever is given in the first menu. I can change bullet, give the style, this one. Okay, now you can change. You can see the text in this. Now let's see how to assign color, border and background in your report. To assign background color to the paragraph, first select the paragraph. I want to change the color of this paragraph. Select the area, then go to the format menu. Then one pop down menu will appear. Select the paragraph. Here you will get so many options, but you go to the area, then color. Which color you want to give? Yes, I want to give this color. Okay, when you click OK, you can see the paragraph background color is changed. Now you can assign the border also to the paragraph. I want to give the border to the same paragraph. First select the area, then go to the format menu. Once again, paragraph. Which border you want to give? I want to give the all four borders. You can have the option of left and right. You can have top and bottom. You can have only one left margin, but I want all four borders. And here I can change the style of the line. I want thick, thin line with large gap. And I can change the color of also green. And just click on OK. Now you can see the border. Your text is inside, selected text is now inside the border, and see the style of the line and the color of the line. In this, now I will tell you page formatting. First, setting up basic page layout using style. Page style define the basic layout of all pages in the document. It includes page size, margins, header, footer, border and background, numbers of columns, etc. The default style is assigned to the new document by default. It appears on the text taskbar of the writer window. Here you can see default page style. Just click on the default style on the taskbar. Here when you click over here, you can change the page format. Now by default it is letter, but I will change it to A4 size. I can change the width also. I can change the height also. I can change orientation also. Now it is portrait, but I can change it to landscape. Here are the option for the margin, left, right, top and bottom, and page layout I can change, and just click on apply. Okay, now you can see, now from the portrait it's now changed to the landscape. Now see how to insert a page break. Suppose you are having the long document, you are dealing with the large data. In this page you want to create a new page over here, so just click on insert menu. When you click on the insert menu, here the pop down menu will appear. Click on page break. Now you can see where you were, the cursor was there, the rest of the text came to the next page. So in this way we can use the page break also. Now your text is having two pages, your report is having two pages, and you are page number 2, page 2 of 2. Student, in a multi-page document, it becomes necessary to add a header and footer to document for more readability. Headers appear at the top of every page. Footers appear at the bottom of a page. Headers and footers are specified by page style. Therefore, all the pages with the same page style will display the same header and footer. To insert the header in your document, click on Insert menu, Header and Footer. First, you select on Header, Default Page Style, Report 1. I want to print as a heading in all the pages. Once again, to insert the footer, go to the Insert menu, Footer, Default Page Style, and you give the name School. Now it's over. Now you can change page number 1, header is there. Page number 2 also header is there. And you can see the footer also, St. Paul's School. This will appear in all the pages of your document. Now you can see how to give page number also in your document. Page number. You start page number 1, then here it will come. Page number, so automatically come page number 2. Now student, I will show you how to insert images, shapes, special characters in a document. The regular text in the document can be made attractive and more informative by inserting the various elements like images, shapes or the special color. So how to, first I will tell you how to insert an image. So click on Insert menu and click on Image. This will ask the picture from where you want to get the picture. Suppose I simply open the pictures library and I want this image over here. You can see this image here. You can change the width and the size and the color and the alignment, but I simply click on the picture and make it small. In this way you can insert the picture, you can change the alignment. When you click over here, you will get the menu to change the alignment, transparency, border, and you can crop the pictures also. All the options you will get when you click on the inserted image. How to insert the special character or shapes? I will tell you. Sometimes while you are working with the mathematical data, so you need shapes, or if you are drawing the flow chart, then also you need the flow chart, you need the shapes, special shapes. So just click on Insert Shape, and here you will get the number of items in the drop down menu. You click, I am choosing flow chart. In the flow chart, all the menus are there. So I want to start the, I want decision box, and where I want, here you can change the color of the image. You can change into the orange color, you can change into red color, you can change the size. When you click over here, you can change the size and alignment of the pictures also. In this way you can insert any shape also. Then how to insert the special character? Here you will get the menu to change the special character. You can insert any of the special character. This, all the mathematical sign are there. You can choose and simply insert. So it gets inserted inside the flowchart process box. In this way children, you can insert, you can make your document very attractive. You can use any formula, any mathematical formula. You can type by using the special character. You can make your document attractive by inserting the picture, and you can insert any kind of shapes to draw the flowchart or to do the mathematical or any scientific formula. You can apply by using all these special characters. Now children, as per your requirement, you can divide the same page into 2 or 3 columns. So I want to divide this particular page into 2 columns. So I will go to the format menu, then I will come to the column. Now it is a single column, but I want to change into double column, equal size double column, and I will change. You can see this page divided into two columns. I want this image into second part of the, so simply I will go over here and you can see one side is text, another side is picture is there. You can change the divide the page into three columns also. Once again go to the format menu, columns, this time I want three equal. There is another option, two column with a different size, and the two column with a different size left and right. I will choose three equal size. You can see children, the same page is divided into three column. So as per your requirement you can change the same page into two or three column, maybe equal size, or you can have the different size also of the partition. With this, we have come to an end of this video. In my next video, I will explain how to insert and format a table in LibreOffice Writer.